Hey there. Let's dive into how you can work with stablecoins on the Hedera network using Stablecoin Studio. Stablecoin Studio is a set of open source software that helps you create and manage stablecoins in a few hours or days instead of weeks or months. It provides four key components. The first two are a web application and a command line interface, or CLI, that issuers and admins can use to create, manage, and operate their stablecoins without having to write code or smart contracts. The third component is a TypeScript SDK for users that want to customize and build their own application or integrate with existing systems and solutions. And the fourth component is a set of audited, open source, and enterprise-grade smart contracts that users can deploy to operate their stablecoins on Hedera. If we look at the flow of operations in this solution, the stablecoin admin can use either the web application or the CLI to issue and manage stablecoins on Hedera. These two components rely on the stablecoin SDK, which actually interacts with the Hedera smart contract service to perform operations like role management, proof of reserve, mint and burn, freeze and unfreeze, pause and unpause, and wipe tokens. The smart contract also enables setting an external cash-in limit for the stablecoin via an oracle to help prevent under-collateralized issuance of tokens, and that increases the confidence and transparency in this process. And finally, we see that the end users can perform peer-to-peer transactions with the stablecoin via the Hedera token service, so things like transfers, managing allowances, or token associations. The importance of this architecture is that it shows a solution that uses both the Hedera smart contract service and the Hedera token service to maximize the benefits for the stablecoin admin and for the end users. That's because the token management can be done securely via smart contracts, and peer-to-peer operations can happen with very low cost, high throughput, and fast finality via the Hedera token service. Now let's jump into how you can install Stablecoin Studio. And starting with requirements, you will need at least version 18.13 of Node.js, version 0.816 or greater for a Solidity compiler, TypeScript 4.7 or newer, and of course the Git command line for cloning the GitHub repository. You're also going to need a Hedera testnet account, which you can get for free on the Hedera portal, and a Hedera wallet with signing capabilities. Now, in this case, we're going to use Hashback, which is a browser extension wallet. So with those requirements in mind, the first step is to clone the GitHub repo, and we're going to start by grabbing this web URL. Now, in the terminal in VS Code, we're going to clone the repo with the command git clone, and the URL and a period at the end. Now the period just makes sure that we clone in this current folder that is also already in my workspace. So now we have all the files of the project cloned locally, and here you see the folders for the key components that we mentioned earlier. So the CLI for creating and managing tokens via a command line. You also have the contracts folder with the source code for those smart contracts used by this solution. You also have the SDK folder with the capabilities for those who want to customize or extend the solution, or perhaps integrate it with other of your existing tools. And the web folder for the code of the web application. Now we have to install the software dependencies to be able to run these components. And we do that with the command npm install. Doing this in the parent folder installs all the dependencies for all the components, but you can also install dependencies by individual component if you prefer that approach as well. Now, this is going to take a few minutes, so I'm going to speed through this part. And now that we have all the dependencies installed, we're ready to create our first stablecoin with the command line interface. So we'll change our working directory to this CLI folder. And then we can start the stablecoin wizard with this command npm run start colon wizard. And so what you see there is that this is going to bring up the CLI tool in this VS Code terminal. Now the first check that the tool does is to see if we have a configuration file defined in the path. Now if you don't have one, you don't have to worry. The tool will ask you if you automatically want to create one, so that's what we will do. It also checks if we want to create a new network. In this case, we'll work with some of the existing defaults like PrevioNet, Mainnet, and Testnet. In this case, we'll choose Testnet. Next, we'll enter the ID of our Hedera account. In this case, this is my Testnet account, and the corresponding private key for that account. Let's point out that this account belongs to Testnet one more time. And at this point, we don't want to enter any additional accounts. We can also configure a factory contract for managing our tokens. In this case, we'll work with the default Testnet contract that is available for anyone at this address for this quarter. Remember that this will change with Testnet resets. In this case, we don't have to worry about PrevioNet. And we're also going to use the default for mirror nodes and also JSON RPC relay services. Now that our account and factory contract is configured, we can go ahead and proceed to create our first stablecoin. In this case, I'm just going to enter the default values like Hedera coin, HTC for symbol. I'm not going to worry too much about some of these parameters here. We're not going to worry about KYC or custom fees, but these are all capabilities that are at your disposal. And in this case, we'll manage this token with the factory contract that we provided before. And here now we see a confirmation for the token that we're about to create with all the parameters that we just specified. And here we can see a URL to a Network Explorer confirming our transaction where we can see more details. And the next question we get is if we want to operate with this newly created stablecoin. In this case, we say yes. And here we see some of the operations that we can now perform for this token. Finally, let's set up the web application as well. So let's change the directory accordingly. And here we have to configure our .env file. So we start by renaming the file. Then we add three variables. The first one is the factory contract address for Testnet, just like we did for the CLI. And remember that this will change every quarter with the quarterly Testnet resets. We also add a mirror node URL. In this case, is the public Testnet mirror node. And we also add a JSON RPC URL. Here we're using Hash.io for Testnet. And keep in mind that Hash.io is a community service provided by Sorrels Labs. And depending on your needs, you can always use commercial grade providers like Arkaya, Validation Cloud, or others, or even host your own. So with those changes in place, we run the command npm start. And there you see the web UI indicating that you're ready to issue stablecoins interactively once a wallet is paired. So to recap, in this video, you saw an introduction to Stablecoin Studio. You saw how to clone the repo and install all the dependencies. And you also saw how to set up the CLI and the web application to start creating and managing stablecoins on Hedera. Be sure to keep watching the other videos in the series to learn how to create stablecoins, how to manage them, and to learn about the proof of reserve capabilities in Stablecoin Studio. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.